making sure the outgoing stream didn't make me look like I gained 15,000 pounds.
No, that's not what does it.
Thank you.
It's
was that one bite
the suit doesn't
cookie,
make
huh?
you look fat. Just, your face looks,
just
makes you look
fat.
You know, camera always adds 10 pounds. How many cameras are on him?
Yeah. Did you eat 5 cameras?
Yeah. Well, don't eat them. All right, here we go.
How's the cat?
Fine, how's yours?
Wasn't asking you. Dave.
Oh, is Lynn back?
So yes. Then. Okay, good.
Yes,
Lynn. Digital Phil wants to play Friends games with you.
Oh, yeah? I haven't played any Friends games in a while.
That's because no one wants to play with him.
Because I beat everybody.
Really? You're sending out the stream of him blowing his nose?
Yeah, nice.
That was very awesome. Because that's what everybody wants to see.
Hey, we're genuine around here.
John, you're the fat one. Yes, that is true.
No, he is not.
I'm the fat one.
You lost a lot of weight.
I did lose a lot of weight. I'd lose even more if I'd stopped drinking all this Coke and stuff.
Well, if the Verve would get here, then that's all you would have to drink, and
that's
then
true.
You would lose weight just by not having those Cokes.
That's right, because they're only like 5 calories per bottle or something ridiculous.
45, but...
Whatever.
Well, let's get going. I'm waiting on the go. Yes, we do have a meeting.
All right, so John's going to kick it?
Yup.
We're fine. I'm going to kick it.
Please don't kick it. I would really like to continue having a business partner.
Are y'all ready?
Ready.
Excuse me.
We're going to get this thing going, guys. Hey, Brandon
J,
what's happening? There's no comments on the YouTube channel? Or is the screen just messed up?
No, there's just no comments.
Okay.
Oh, YouTubers, what's up with you? No commenting?
I'll check them. You have to reload the page a couple times.
So that's what the P stands for, fat. But with a P, P-H-A-T-T.
Which means you're cool, yo.
Bad. He's a bad mother. Shut your mouth. Talk about John P.
All right, here we go.
Glad you amuse yourself, John P.
Camera 4. What's wrong with it? I'm just looking.
I really shouldn't be standing up in these. Heels.
Because you're way taller than me?
So why'd you get them? You're not supposed to stand in them. That kind of defeats the purpose of having shoes.
They're the only
shoes.
Your feet.
They're the only shoes that actually have heels that I wear.
DP likes it when I do the Humpty Hump. The Humpty Dance.
All right, here we go.
All right.
The Humpty Dance is your chance to do the hump.
All right, and in 3, 2...
He never got to 1.
I know. I don't know what happened.
I don't know. Just
all of a sudden, y'all are waiting for 1, and in 3, 2, the 1 is an implied beat. That's the whole idea behind the countdown.
I think we forgot how to
you're
do
the
this.
One who's supposed to start,
okay.
Not me.
All right.
Josh, y'all are
do it again.
it's all on her, okay? All the professionalism here is centered on this side.
What happened was,
to tell people I know
he's like 3-2, and then Pablo comes running in here. I thought he was like being directed to start doing something.
Is Renee in the house?
Pablo just doesn't want a shoe thrown at him.
All right, let's do this.
You want to walk in? Here we go. And yes, I do want you to do that. And in 3, 2, 1.
Hey guys, I'm Callie Lewis.
And I am John P. On today's Geek Beat Live, net neutrality, it's out the window.
Google's getting into home automation.
Burritos from a vending machine.
Yeah, that'll happen when pigs glow.
Huh. Well, it all begins now.
You're watching CES Live. Powered by Ustream.tv, the most powerful way to stream live video, and by NewTek, makers of the TriCaster.
Welcome back to the studio.
Gordon McLeod in the chat room says hashtag fired.
Right. This is not CES Live.
I'm still in CES, but I'm still recovering.
I got it. It's understandable.
No more CES. But I can't take it.
You gotta admit that intro rocked and the voice was perfect.
Oh yeah.
For those of you who don't know, that was Dave Curley's voice.
Right.
It does not sound like it.
That was Dave's announcer voice.
So we are back from CES. It was an amazing time. It was a blast. I hope you guys enjoyed all the coverage. We had quite a lot of it, a lot.
You know, Ben is pointing out in the chat room that we had at least 20 hours of live CES coverage, which is a lot.
The question is, how many people actually watched all that coverage?
The funny thing is that I drove for 40 hours.
Man!
Literally, I had 40 hours in the truck with Mark Ramsey for us to do
20 hours of live coverage. Oh, we need to find somebody who can drive for you as opposed to having you to do that.
Well, you drive me insane all the time.
That's true.
So, I don't know. Does that count? I don't know.
Yeah, as DDP is saying in the chat room, my voice didn't make it.
You're mostly recovered. I'd say you're about 80%.
I'm still kind of like dealing with a little bit of crap, but mostly recovered. And
if you guys didn't see it, you can go check out all the archived CES live coverage if you go to geekme.tv/CES Live.
Well,
and you can hear her voice going out on her in the last few days. She sounds like a 12-year-old boy or like a 13-year-old boy going through puberty.
It was pretty bad.
Her voice is cracking and stuff like that.
And then we, of course, had to go to the auto show in Detroit where we saw some fun, awesome stuff.
The Detroit Auto Show.
Just a quick update, though, on the CES giveaways. Lots of you asking. We had like 120 giveaways.
No, I thought it was over 130.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It was 1,000.
Somewhere in that range.
No, a lot.
130 giveaways for you guys, and thank you so much for participating in that. Just an update for all of you winners. If I haven't contacted you specifically, don't worry about it. I got your information, but I'm just waiting on confirmations from the companies that are sending them out in order to let you know that it's gone out. So
yeah, it just takes a while to get back.
I can't say I got the information and then go back and like, it's just a lot of work. So
yes, indeed. All right, what else do we have? Patreon has been going nuts.
You guys are amazing.
You guys are truly, truly amazing.
While we were at CES, so many pledges. Thank you.
That's right. Yeah, we really appreciate it. If you haven't yet had a chance to chip in with a little bit of support, head on over to geekbeat.tv/patron, and you can join as a patron of Geekbeat.
Of the arts.
Just even $1 a month helps us keep bringing you all this great content, whether it's live at CES, live here, you know, with our normal show or just our regular programming and broadcast. We're needing your help because we want to give you even more. We want to bring on more staffers, get more content, do great things. So thank you so much for those of you who are supporting us, and we love you.
Indeed. Speaking of patrons, one of our major patron is Verve.
That's right.
So if you guys didn't see John's post about it, it's actually really, really cool. It's a, sorry,
it's an energy delicious. Drink.
I need some right now, but I don't have any.
All I have is Dr. Pepper.
Cough
at
button,
the
Curly.
Yeah.
You talk about Verve.
Here's the thing, okay? This is an energy drink, but first of all, for those of you like me who aren't so much into healthy stuff, when you look at the can, it's listing all these vitamins and things in it. So it makes you worried. You're like, that cannot be good. And then, there you go.
Thank you.
And then when you start chugging it, you're like, wow, this is delicious. That's not supposed to happen.
Right.
It can't be both good for me and delicious. It should be one or the other. But it's not. It's both. And you can get some if you go to vervegeek.com.
Awesome. Vervegeek.
.com.
Like Geekbeat.
Like Geekbeat.
Cool.
It's my new vice.
Yes. Right. It's all of our new vices.
Anyway, I drank all of it that I had. So I'm waiting on some more.
I just want to say I did not actually get much Verve while at CES. People were stealing them.
They were. It was bad.
It's the Mobile Nations clowns.
Yeah, okay. That's right.
Those guys did it.
Like Renee.
Anyway, Ken is going to chop our heads off in a second because we have to stop for a quick commercial break, and then we'll be right back and hop right into today's news.
Woo!
Sheila Friend is over there in YouTube land. Seabase 1989. Eric Stratford, M7MD Videos. Test. Hello, geeks. Hello. Well, hello.
David Foster from Verve says that 48 cans are coming to us and the party is only for me. Thank you.
Nice.
Ha.
48 cans. 48 cans won't last very long.
Yeah.
Until Tuesday.
Yeah, I drink.
Sorry, Faith Tech.
I drink at least two a day, one in the morning, and one like in the afternoon.
So keep you going.
And you get that little
so,
slump.
A case is what 24 pack? That
so.
Will last me approximately less than 2 weeks.
Uh oh, we gotta figure something out there.
It's like crack. Once you start drinking it,
we need to be on auto ship.
You got to have it. But the good news is you can't complain because it's healthy.
That's true.
Nobody can tell me.
No, nobody can anything. Be like, you're drinking too much.
Digital Phil just asked, did Ralph Cirilla smell? No,
no
he didn't
of course
smell.
Not. What are you talking about?
No. Does it? Why? See, he doesn't have a bad reputation or anything, does he?
No. He's just being him.
Look
and
at
of
Renee.
Course.
John slammed those at CS. I think he played Verve Pong at one
nice.
Point.
Nice.
That's a good idea, actually.
And I just want to say, Ralph or the entire gang over at Sirius have never made me feel uncomfortable in terms of, you know.
Anything inappropriate.
Like, yeah, people ask me all the time, you're on Howard 101? Like, that doesn't seem to fit. But those guys are amazing gentlemen and have never made me feel uncomfortable.
You know what? Even Howard himself,
right.
although he can be really crude and rude, he knows where to draw the line. He knows who he can do that with and get away. I've never seen him say something like that to someone who clearly would be very offended by it.
Right.
You know, so you know they know where the boundaries are and they abide by them.
All right.
Who was the young
ready?
Woman with the long, beautiful hair? She's pretty and very exotic.
Are she you? Is indeed. She's talking about Josie, Pablo's
girlfriend. Oh, here. Here. Oh, in the studio. I thought we were talking about at the live show.
Yes.
Ken's trying to keep us going.
All right. We're going to come back if I can keep. We need a fame spot on the end of this one.
Oh, don't you worry. I've got one.
I may not make it.
We need to get you some cough drops or something.
Do you have that bag of cough drops I gave you?
I used
Ben said, Howard is an entertainer, not a jerk. That's true. Hello from Miami.
Over the last week and a half?
Hello, Miami. How are you?
Hello, Tokyo.
JCKM77.
All right. Ready?
Sound like a motor. All right, here we go. And in 3, 2. What? Oh.
Hey, guys. Welcome back to Geek Beat Live. I'm Callie.
I'm John P. Welcome back. Callie is going to struggle through today's show.
Sorry.
And every time she starts coughing, I'm just going to ramble mindlessly, which is what I usually do anyway, and just cover that up. How's
All
that
right.
sound?
That sounds like a plan. Go team.
Yay.
Cough. All right, so we have a ton to cover because we've been gone so long, and a lot actually happened the week after CES, which is incredible because that never happens.
Yeah.
Usually it dies after CES, but...
Not this year.
Google started out by making headlines by buying Nest.
For $3.2 $1 billion.
So if you're not familiar, Nest is the smart thermostat company. They also now have a smart, what are those things called? The
carbon monoxide / fire detector kind of thing or something?
That thing.
$3.2 billion friggin' dollars?
Who was smoking
what at Google? There is no
very interesting
way Nest can be worth $3 billion.
Well, it depends on what Google wants to do with it.
No way.
I haven't seen any numbers in terms of how many customers Nest has or anything like that, but
not $3.2 billion worth.
No. But you know, it'll be that they take up companies, they buy companies, and then they shut them down, of course.
Yeah. Wow, Dustin.
And then they take that technology and do something with it.
That means I'm never buying one of those now.
Because Google owns it.
Wow.
So basically, Nest is going back into beta.
I don't know what is going on with that. But anyway, Google bought Nest, so that's big, big news. You know who else is buying people? Both T-Mobile and AT&T, they want to buy you.
They do. They want to pay you to come over from their competitors. So if you, if you're a T-Mobile customer, AT&T will pay you $450 just to come on over.
To quit them. Basically, it's $200 for a credit, like probably for your exit fee penalty that you have to pay over there, if there is one.
Right.
And then it's $250 credit for towards a new phone,
like a
because these things aren't always interchangeable. Okay. But T-Mobile says, you know what, AT&T? Ha!
We'll pay you $650 instead to come over to us.
And that's 200 more, isn't it?
Is it?
And
I was calculating it at 125.
Not only that, they will pay you whether you're coming from Sprint, Verizon, or AT&T. Right. They don't care.
It is pretty impressive the way the phone companies are just kind of going at it these days.
I'll tell you what's impressive. Okay, for the last decade, we have been living under these carriers just forcing us to sign multi-year contracts and sticking it to us, okay? And all of a sudden, T-Mobile came out and goes, you know what? Screw all that contract stuff. We're not doing that anymore. And by the way, we're not subsidizing the phones either. You can basically take out a loan and pay it off over time, but you're going to own your phone. No contracts. Bring it. We're going to give you the love.
And they came in, they made that announcement, and just revamped the entire industry.
It changed everything. I'm so happy. I love T-Mobile, and I'd actually switch over to T-Mobile if they had a decent network.
Oh!
Just kidding, all you T-Mobile people. I'm just kidding. But seriously.
That's not necessarily true. It's
not true. We're using Verizon Wireless, though. T-Mobile has a great network. So does Sprint. So does AT&T. They're all big, great networks. But we have found in our travels that we have more consistency with the use of Verizon Wireless, and we travel
just
a lot.
Just throughout, okay? But it always depends on where you are in your coverage map and how much you're traveling.
We are using Verizon Wireless, although we pay more for it.
Right.
But for us, it's a business expense, and it's one of those situations where it's like, okay, we believe that we get more consistent coverage out of town, and it costs us more, but we need it, so we're willing to pay more. That is not necessarily the way a normal individual or family would act.
Business, so
it'd be better to save the money.
Right. Now, Sprint also did something very interesting.
What'd they do?
They came up with a family plan.
Oh, this is the dumbest name ever.
This is pretty bad. I always thought it. I just kept looking at it. I was like, who made this typo?
Yeah, at first I was like, Ben, your spelling is atrocious. But I mean, you didn't just spell it family once.
Just
you did
like
it like five
times.
I mean, you need to get your spell checker fixed. Nope.
Family and friends plan.
Friends and family. It's the family plan.
So basically, you can combine. Very interesting. You can get unlimited calling and text plus a gig of data for $55 a month. You can upgrade yearly, like unlimited daily data for $20 a month extra. But here's where it gets very interesting: is the more lines you add to your plan, the less money you pay. So
per line, you mean?
Total, really. So two lines cost $50 a month. three lines will cost $45 a month.
What?
And if you go, if you have like between 7 and 10, you can go up to 10 lines, then it's going to be like $25 a month.
Wait, $25 a month for 10 phones?
That's my understanding. If I have it wrong, you've got to tell me. But that's what I'm reading.
And we then might be changing also, to Sprint.
I know, right? And then also, you can actually individually pay for these. Like, you can have them paid separately, all the different lines. So, in essence,
you could team up with your friends.
You could team up with your friends. Like, we could all be on the same plan, essentially, here at the office, and you get to save money.
That's crazy talk.
That is.
That's what we're doing Monday.
Yeah. I know. Switching to Sprint.
All right. Let me tell you the worst thing that has happened all year. Possibly all decade at this point. This is the absolute worst thing that's happened this decade. Net neutrality was struck down by a court in Washington, D.C. It's the D.C. District Circuit Court of Appeals. And what happened was there was basically a law that said carriers had to maintain net neutrality, meaning that, let's say, if GeekBeat is broadcasting our show through the interwebs, you cannot deprioritize our traffic for NBC, who's broadcasting through the interwebs, and NBC pays more money. Right. In other words, it allows Callie and I to be on an equal footing with
anyone
Ellen
else.
Or Oprah or whatever, okay? We're all equal. It's net neutrality. Well, the District Court of Appeals said, you can't do that. That law is not valid, and they struck it down.
Right.
So now the FCC needs to come out with some other way of regulating these carriers. And
well, because it's very possible that the carriers go crazy with all sorts of you know, favoritism.
You know, the big thing, it's not in our notes here, but the big thing is well, it may be, but I didn't read it, but the big thing is that the FCC was not treating internet backbone carriers the same way that they were treating telcos. Okay, so phones have to all be treated the same. And they were saying, well, because you're classifying them as a different class, you can't do the same thing. So what I'm hoping happens is that the FCC goes back and revamps things in a way that will maintain the legal structure and treat all telco and internet carriers all the same, regardless. It's all data nowadays. Whatever it is should be treated neutrally. And this, my friends, is, and I cannot stress this enough, and I'm serious, I'm not joking about this. This is the single biggest threat to the internet that has ever existed.
And you know, everybody was paying a lot of attention to it when it was going on back, you know, a couple years ago. But now that everybody's stopped really paying attention to it, it's potentially
it.
Even bigger threat because everybody's not up in arms.
John.
Yeah.
John, could this open the door for antitrust lawsuits? Because this is going to basically incentivize them, the carriers, to act monopolistically, being that they are content providers and backbones.
Yes, it could. It could. It's hard to say what all the ramifications could be, although the carriers right now are saying, we're not going to make any changes. We just didn't like that law hovering over us, which is true. But if I guarantee you, and remember, I used to be an executive at one of those companies. I guarantee you that if this law, if nothing changes, give it a year or two, those guys at the top will start figuring out how they can capitalize on this, and all hell will break loose. It will be terrible. Anywho,
we've got to
take a quick break.
We're going to talk about burritos coming up in the next segment. My question to you, and we want you to leave a fame spot, quick video at geekbeat.tv/famespot is, would you eat a burrito out of a vending machine of all things?
That's a good question.
Would you?
I might.
And we're back.
I'm sorry, I just came up with something. You can change it
later. I had a better one.
Okay, change it. You always change the fame spot.
You didn't ask me. I thought you were going to throw it to me.
Oh.
Mine was going to be, what's the weirdest thing you've eaten out of a vending machine?
Oh, you should change it.
I'm going to.
Okay.
I'm going to change it.
You always do.
All right. Eric said, wow, I just missed a bunch of the show. Hi, can you tell me how I
could
get...
I'm not sure
how. Funtaman, hi, can you tell me how I could get a total private IM software? Totally private instant messaging. Well, for example, Adium will allow you to instant message between two different people in, and you can enable encryption between those two points. But both people on both ends have to say yes for it to be completely encrypted. That's one way you could could get encrypted IM. But also
iMessage is by default.
iMessage is encrypted.
That's encrypted by default.
Yeah, true. But I wouldn't really
I don't know if I would trust
that.
I don't know if I would trust it, but
hasn't part of the conversation been that the government is kind of pissed about it because they can't actually crack that? The NSA can't get into that encryption?
No, I thought it was that they could.
I thought it was that
they
couldn't.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
That Apple's statements were, hey, we're secure, trust us.
Yeah.
BBM?
Yeah, I trust you. You're
encrypted.
A giant monopolistic corporation. Sure, I trust you.
Did you just say douchebag?
What? Is GeekBeat going to go out of business?
No, of course.
Why would we go out of business?
Maybe he's asking because of the patron stuff.
Net neutrality.
Oh,
yeah, because of net neutrality. They could. They could literally choke us out of business because of net neutrality. If they wanted to, because that thing was struck down today, they could go, you know what? Callie and John, we're just going to deprioritize all the traffic coming out of you guys unless you pay us some exorbitant fee. And it's like mafia all over again.
I'm waiting for the government to start pointing at certain organizations and saying deprioritize them.
All right.
Yeah, I have water, guys. Thank you. It's just not helping.
Lynn's coming in with some hauls for you. Hang on just a second.
Oh, nice.
No, you did not have. Why did you do that?
I
thank you.
You can have one.
I can't really suck on
it. Yeah, you can. Why not? It's better than coffee. If it works.
If it works.
We'll make a joke about it.
Yeah.
That's right, we do it all.
Thank you, Lynn.
All righty.
Just don't smack.
Tubemaker says we need to start a petition. I think somebody already has.
Oh, yeah.
And they're asking me about my watch.
Okay, here we go. Ready?
Let's do it. Hey folks, welcome back to GeekBeat Live. We have solved the Cali coughing problem.
Len
with
actually
a big old bag of hauls. Thanks
Wilkerson
to Lynn.
Went out and got. I was wondering where he disappeared to. I thought he was like, I'm sick of this show. I'm out of here.
Yeah, he went and he actually drove to the store and got her hauls right here live on the show.
I have to say, we have the best people.
We do.
As part of the GeekBeat family.
Awesome. Also, there have been a lot of questions because some of you have noticed that I am wearing a watch today, which I don't often do.
Well, but you're a watch guy.
I do love watches.
You have a lot of watches.
I do have a lot of watches.
You've spent a lot of money on watches over the years.
Yeah, so Holly tells me. So Holly reminds me.
Even
constantly.
I hear about how much money you've spent on watches.
Yes, that is true. I was given a new Martian watch during CES Live, which I was playing with and enjoying. And now I am actually wearing the Pebble watch, which Mark Ramsey talked me into trying out. And it's pretty cool. And just so you guys know, it's tied in with my email and texting and all. So if you were to send me a tweet to @JohnPose, it will pop up on my watch and I can read it on my watch. If you tweet @JohnPose.
Put it on the watch. Let's see if someone does it.
Well, it takes a second, and there's a little bit of a delay. So you send them to me, and if you tweet them at me, then I'll read them off, our next break or something like that.
All right, shall we get to the geeky gadgety news of the week?
Let's do it. What
Google
do we got?
Google is making headlines again by their smart contacts. So the idea. So diabetes is a big issue for a lot of people in the world, specifically in America. I don't have the stats in here. Something like 14 out of 20 people or something. A lot of people have diabetes.
Not 14 out of 20. That would be a lot of people.
I know. That's why I was thinking.
Like 60% of the people.
I know.
No. But a lot of people are faced with diabetes. And the problem is they have to be constantly checking their blood sugar levels.
Yes.
Okay. Well, you know, that could mean pricking your finger constantly till you lose all feeling in your finger. And so, you know, some of the guys over at Google said, hey, you know what? This sounds like a project we want to take on because we like to tackle the weird and difficult stuff. So look at this thing. They've got this little, I don't know, prototype. They just announced this literally today. They're trying to embed a little sensor in a contact that you put in your eyeball, all up in your eye socket. And
I wear contacts. It's not that different.
It measures
the tears.
Yeah, the glucose level or whatever through your tears in your eyeball. Supposedly pretty accurate.
Well, that is the most accurate way. But outside of contacts, how are you going to measure your tears? Like cry into a little vial, you know?
Yeah, cry into
vial,
a little.
And then I go test it. It's not gonna happen. So they are expecting to be able to continue the process of research on these and get them out. Obviously, no date or anything like that yet, but hopefully they make some headway. I mean, Google is known for pushing these types of projects forward.
Well, hey, if they can spend $3.2 billion to buy Nest, they can drop $100 million on development of this product, and then, hey, they'll be in Google eyeballs
Although,
all over the place.
I did notice they said something about the way it would alert you if your levels are in or not
would
good.
Would it vibrate your eyeball?
No, it would like light up, which doesn't do the user any good.
Why not?
Unless you can see that.
No, I'm sure you'd see it. It would be a little glowing
like
color.
A little glow. That would be a little weird. I'd almost
rather
it just like text me or something.
I'd
That'd
like
be
for
awesome.
It to vibrate my eyeball.
They can text you. Anyway.
A vibrating eyeball.
Oh, excuse me. I need to check my blood sugar level, and that'd be awesome.
How about since we're talking about Google? How about getting Android in your car as a native OS that's in your dash, and you don't have to deal with multiple systems? How awesome would that be?
That would be cool. They're catching up with Apple. Back in 2013 at the WWDC, the Worldwide Developer Conference, they announced iOS was coming to the car, so hey, why not get your Google in your car?
That would be
get
awesome.
Get your Google on. Google's going to be in your eyeball, in your car.
They're going to be everywhere.
Google Cloud, I think they already are.
They pretty much are. That's the Open Automotive Alliance.
Wow, we have got...
Oh my gosh, Google.
Filled with Google today. Google, speaking of Google and Google Plus...
Maybe we should do a Google show.
Maybe...
How do you feel... Yeah, we're going to change this to Google Live. How do you feel about the fact that 2 million people can now email you anytime they want through your Google Plus?
Honestly, I don't know why everybody's up in arms about this. I don't have a problem with it whatsoever. Okay. It hasn't been a problem, and I would rather people email me as opposed to message me on Google Plus, because I never see those messages anyway.
Yeah, but you say that now because you're not getting as many emails as you are getting messages.
That's true. I do tend to get quite behind on email, so maybe it won't turn out to be good.
So for Callie and I, notifications on Google Plus are completely useless because there's so many. It's literally impossible to keep up.
Unless you specifically tag our names, we don't see that notification.
Yeah, we don't, yeah. But what's happening is Google is now allowing you to send an email to anyone through Google Plus, but there is a setting that you can turn that off in your Google Plus settings. They sent me, and I'm sure they sent you an email.
No.
They
don't send me anything until they send it to you first, I
got an email that said,
very loved.
Hey, we're about to start doing this thing where anybody can email you, but because you have a whole large number of followers, we have not turned that on automatically for you. So I guess for most
people... Wait a sec. They're telling you... Because you have a large number of followers. Meanwhile, she has 2 million.
I'm sure they sent it to her, too.
Yeah, well, I don't know.
I'm sure they did.
See?
Well, I am a little more important than she is.
Yeah, apparently. When it comes to Google, you are more important. You get everything Google first. I am so upset about this. But a couple more quick things about Google. They opened up Google Play Movies into the iOS App Store, so you can now download that. And also, we're going to just move on at this point. Got a couple other really cool things.
Do it.
We got to get to those burritos before we go back to commercial
break.
That's
true.
Roku. Everybody knows the Roku boxes, the little set-top boxes.
Some of you may be watching Geek Beat on one right now. Thank you very much.
Thank you for doing that. Well, those are awesome, but actually Roku is now coming out with Roku TV that will be integrated directly into a lot of the major TVs as a smart app.
Now, they've had some. They've had another way of integrating Roku into the TVs before. You could buy their little Roku stick.
Right.
And plug it into an MHL port on TVs that had that. But now they're building Roku into the smart functionality of TVs from Hisense and from TCL, I believe.
Yep.
And I'm sure there will be more others, which is, I think, fantastic.
Yes.
Because that will allow Roku to keep doing their development work and adding new channels to Roku, and the TV manufacturers, who are notoriously bad about updating their smart TVs, I'm looking at you, Sharp, they won't have to do it anymore because Roku's going to take care of it for them.
All right, and now to come back to the burritos question.
One last very important update.
There is now a burrito box, a couple of locations in California only at this point, that will allow you to order a burrito from a vending machine, like kind of like a Red Box.
It's like Red Box.
And Freebirds together.
My favorite. We had Freebirds for lunch today.
Yes, we did.
This machine will make you a burrito.
In 90 seconds, actually, and it costs $3, so even cheaper than most burrito places out there.
Crazy, crazy.
The question is how it tastes.
It'll probably taste like crap. You'd probably be better off just going down to the local 7-Eleven, where you can also get a burrito or a hot dog or whatever.
That's been sitting on the warmer for hours.
They're probably better.
Maybe. We'll see. So, speaking of burritos and vending machines, actually, you had a better question for our fame spot.
I'm changing up the fame spot question,
Let's
folks.
Let's do it.
Question I have for you is, what is the weirdest thing you've ever eaten out of a vending machine? That's what I want to know. Head on over
bread.
That was true. Bread in a can. Head on over to geekbee.tv/fame spot. Let us know, and we'll put your answer right here on television. Hey, I've noticed you haven't coughed. You didn't cough that whole segment.
No, it's helping.
That is good. Way to go, Lynn.
Yep.
Faith Tech, tastetheburritobox.com. Yikes.
Ooh, Taco Bell. That sounds good.
Taco Bell.
I want a Taco Bell taco.
You go to Walmart or you come out of Kroger or something, and, you know, there's a Coke machine, so you get yourself a couple of Cokes or Mountain Dews, pick up a movie at the Red Box, and then get your burritos, and then go home, and it's like, you know, vending machine entertainment night extravaganza.
Yeah, it sounds disgusting, actually.
It really does.
I am sorry, I've been taking up Creepy Kitty's space.
Were you blocking Creepy Kitty?
Yes, apparently I was.
I see. So I thought I wanted Taco Bell when we were on our way to Las Vegas.
And did you get some?
And Mark and I stopped to gas up at the Walmart at the wall. We got our gas. Mm-hmm. Then we went over to Taco Bell.
And?
I got two chicken soft tacos.
Oh, no, go for the crappy beef stuff, the ground beef.
I wasn't going to do that when I was going to be spending 20 hours in the car, okay? So I got the chicken soft tacos. God almighty, they are horrible compared to Freebirds. Like, I am so spoiled by Freebirds.
Yeah.
The Taco Bell ones were just disgusting, and it used to not bother me, but all of a sudden, I mean, the chicken tasted like it was frozen out of a bag, which it was. The cheese tasted like shredded plastic fake, which it is. The salsa, the quote salsa that comes out of little bags, it was just
I should tell that email from Taco Bell sponsor the show that no.
We'd be happy to have Taco Bell sponsor it. No, I'm just kidding. No, I really wouldn't do it. I would not have Taco Bell as a sponsor of the show. Watch them run it on YouTube as a run for the border.
All right.
Sorry.
Let's come back.
I do want Freebirds as a sponsor, though, so I can get all the Freebirds that I can eat.
Oh, poor you. You've eaten there like 3 days in a row since we've been back.
If I could only eat and drink two things, I guess I would drink Verve and eat Freebirds. And if I could mix those two together.
Like
verve birds, like verve birds. I could combine them all into one like healthy little drink, and I could just go on a liquid diet, a verve birds diet. Sounds good to me.
I think let's keep them separate.
Why not?
Jonathan Hatfield, I don't think you saw this episode. We did an interview with Structure.io, which basically is a camera and an app that that creates 3D models of things, and they did a 3D printed,
Yeah.
3D version of me. Although they didn't go all the way around, but
did they do a 3D version of you?
Yeah. He did this thing, and so he got like the front half of me.
Yeah.
And it was really cool. It was really awesome.
Jonathan had a good idea. We should do a we should print and sell a 3D right. version of you and donate the proceeds to charity. Well, why
that,
not?
On that interview, because he was like, you can just upload it straight to
wherever, and they can all print.
Yeah, exactly. Anyone can everybody print their can own print Callie Lewis. Callie. That'd be
and
scary.
Then John Yero said, did you guys play with the new LG OLED TV? How was that? Yeah. Ken goes, eh.
That, no, hang on. That means it's the most amazing.
Yeah, but for Ken, from Ken, I mean, it actually got a noise out of Ken.
He's
that's impressive.
One. That's, he's going to build his life around it.
And that's some of his other things.
Yeah, I mean, those. First of all, the new OLED TVs look beautiful. Especially because everything they're showing off now is 4K. It's all 4K, and so they're amazing looking. The colors are fantastic, and of course now some of them are curved, like the LG. You can remote control curve it, so that if you're sitting close to it, you can make it kind of more, yeah. you know, better visibility. They're crazy cool nowadays.
I can't say I'm totally sold on the idea of curved displays yet. Until, you know, things progress a little bit more. But pretty cool as an idea.
Okay, one last thing. Then Ken's making us go, oh, read the tweets. Oh, I didn't get any. You know what? I didn't get the tweets. Did you send me the tweets? Twitter. Let's see here. hang on. I'm supposed to have tweets,
Samsung
right?
and LG had those, guys. Fundament says, I'd like to taste a 3D printed Twinkie. I've never tasted an American Twinkie. They don't look healthy, though. Oh, they're not. They're so far from healthy. But they're awesome. I actually haven't still had a Twinkie since the whole debacle.
You really
need
haven't?
To go buy, I need to go buy a Twinkie. And I want some Taco Bell and a Twinkie. Look what you guys are doing to me. Amazing. That yeah, one bite of a cookie. I'm gone.
What is going on? You guys sent me a whole bunch of tweets.
And it didn't come through on your Pebble?
I got to fix it. Sorry,
right,
guys.
Let's do that after the show.
And there's some funny tweets, too, by the way. There's some good ones here.
And there goes the Pebble sponsorship.
And there goes Pebble. All right, let's do it.
Hey guys, welcome back to Geek Beat Live. John, would you like to pay attention to the camera as opposed to your phone?
I'm trying to get my tweets working.
We're you guys doing a have show
been,
here.
You guys have been tweeting me like crazy, and I was promising you I'd be able to read them on my Pebble, but nothing. I'm getting nothing, but I don't know why. It should be working.
And at the Creepy Kitty got upset on Twitter that he wasn't getting any FaceTime on the show, so I moved him.
I see why. Here's why. My Pebble wasn't connected for some reason.
Uh-oh.
This says connecting. Connecting. That doesn't work for me. Connecting. Cancel. We need to click
right,
to
put
connect.
Put the Pebble away.
Connecting.
Uh-huh.
Connecting.
So, while he tries to get his thing working, I want you guys to take a look at this
That's
video.
That's what she said.
this video produced by, I think, Modo. And they had, this is actually just a viral video. It went crazy this week. 30 million views already. And, well, you know what? I'm not really going to set it up or anything.
Just watch. Just watch.
I don't know if anybody can hear us. Not CEO's life.
Okay,
hashtag not
right.
CEO's life.
Right. Oh
my God, that is hilarious. Like I said, 30 million views. I mean, they just went crazy. I can't imagine what my reaction would be in that moment either.
Listen, there are two things that are the best things ever in that video. Number one,
vomit.
The projectile vomiting from the little baby. And number two, you didn't see it in that clip. But if you go to geekme.tv/
Live 121.
Then you can watch that video. And so the projectile vomiting. And second is the little baby flipping off cabbies. Did you notice that?
No, I didn't notice that.
Oh, you got to watch it again. The little thing turns his head and flips off a cabbie. It's fantastic.
Crazy. Do you know what's brilliant about that whole deal? That is an ad campaign for a movie.
That's right.
Oh, is it really?
That's what it is. It's an ad campaign.
Devil's
for
Due.
The Satan's Spawn. What is what?
I think it's
Devil's Due.
Devil's Due.
Devil's Due.
I was watching this and wondering, if this is what happened with Rosemary's Baby.
Yep.
I don't know what that means.
It's been baking in the oven.
Rosemary's Baby.
Never mind. Okay. It's a pop culture reference.
It's a movie that was a
classic. Oh, I don't care. Really, I'll learn that later. Right now, we have to talk about glowing pigs.
Well, you said that we wouldn't have burrito boxes until pigs glowed.
You're,
well, guess what? Pigs are now glowing. Tell us about it.
That is just freaky. So, they're using a process called transgenetics, which is basically, making something in one body and transferring those genetics, those genes, into another being, whatever that being that is.
Okay.
The idea being here that they could, as opposed to building something, growing something in a lab, which costs millions of dollars, they could do it more cost efficiently in like a pig and then transfer that gene.
Is that a glowing pig?
Yes, into a human body, for example.
So they can make us glow?
So, yeah, it's not about the glowing. This is really a process that is a reaction to the process that is causing him to
so
glow.
So what are they growing in the pig? An alien? And it's making the pig...
Well, no. They're just...
Side effect of growing an alien in a pig is that it glows.
They basically have it glowing so that you can see that it's actually working and being introduced into the body.
Oh, okay.
But it
Does
is
it wear
pretty
off,
weird.
Or is it permanent?
They didn't go into that. I don't know if it wears off or it's permanent. It would be kind of weird to have us all walking around glowing.
I could hear the...
Not sure about
I could hear,
that.
Like, the heart medication... Right. Ads and stuff saying, some side effects may be death and dismemberment.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
Glowing.
And glowing.
And sleep deprivation due to bioluminescence.
And, Tube Maker said Sam's green ham was actually green.
Right.
Green eggs and ham.
I got that one.
Nice.
I was, actually read Dr. Seuss.
Anyway, hacks.
So.
Let's talk about hacks because this.
I don't know, glowing pigs is kind of a hack.
It is a hack, but this is getting ridiculous, okay? The Target breach, we reported to you guys a few weeks ago. Now, Target is saying, okay, I know we came back and told you it was worse than we thought once, but it's even worse than we thought when we told you it was worse than we thought. Now, 70 million people's emails, contact details, and everything have been compromised by Target.
Yes.
By their inability to keep your data safe, they let an off-the-shelf piece of malware called Black POS, and that's not that's point of sale probably. It's just an off-the-shelf piece of malware. They let it corrupt their system and gave all of our contact details to the criminals. Thank you very much, Target.
Did you know this? We actually found out who, well, not by name, but who actually was, who wrote the malware code.
Uh-huh.
A 17-year-old boy in Russia. So they're not releasing his name, but he is known for this type of malware behavior. I'm just going to call it malware behavior.
Nice. By the way, the Pebble is working again, okay. So you can actually go ahead and tweet me now, and nice. I will get those tweets. They're coming through as we speak.
Awesome. All right. Well, so thank you, 17-year-olds.
Oh, boy.
I think it's time to go to commercial real quick and then come back and talk about robots.
And read the tweets.
And we'll read the tweets. We'll see you in a sec.
Well, I do not know what's going on with this thing.
Do we need to reboot?
We go through the entire CES show and have no problems whatsoever and get
and
back
come
here.
Back and bang.
What did you do on the drive?
Yeah.
Did you roll over and flip the trailer?
You told me I wasn't allowed to talk about the things that Mark and I did on the drive. Thank you, Digital Phil. It felt good. Oh.
Hey, Logan. Oh, 74. It has been a while. Welcome back. Where have you been?
Ben said, stop looking at your watch, Pose. Oh, another one, GK Dave. Send me free birds. GK Dave wants me to send him free birds.
He misses free birds. He said all they have is Taco Bell.
Oh, well, I already...
Let's see how they look coming through.
I just cleared it, unfortunately. We'll have to wait for the next one. When the next one comes, I'll show it to you.
Oh, Pakal, I actually do. We have a puppy friend. I need to bring him in studio.
A puppy friend?
A puppy friend for...
Oh, yes, you do.
Kirby Kitty and Livy the Lobster.
You do have one.
Yes. I'll show you that next week.
Okay.
I'll show you him.
About Lynn.
Oh.
Right.
No. I have to charge him first. I have to charge my puppy. Ready?
Okay, let's do this. Wow, that was a fast commercial. Flying Spaghetti Monster.
Kroger 1998. Yes, we are in the office next week.
I don't know that it's absolutely. Kroger. It's C. Roger.
Oh, C. Roger.
It could be Kroger with a C, but it looks like C. Roger.
Okay, fair
or it
enough.
It could be Kroger 1998, or it could be Kroger 1998, or it could be Kroger 1998.
Sorry. I'm sorry. Well, yes, we are. And when you come visit us next week, you can tell me how it's pronounced.
That's right.
So come on by.
Bring it. She's right.
Like Bobbage.
She's right. You were right. It is Kroger.
Really?
But it could have been C. Roger.
Awesome. C. Roger.
It could have been Kerr Auger.
I shop at Kroger, so I just thought it goes to Kroger.
Yeah, could be.
Anyway.
Oh, here you go. Here you go. Oh, boy.
Show with us.
That's right. We're doing a live show here. Yeah, and you're supposed to be zooming in on the watch. Can you see?
There it is.
It says, that's from Janny.
Vimini, I said Livy the Lobster.
John Pose. Say Callie hi from Green. Tell Callie hi from Green.
Hi, Green.
Hey, John, does that have a light display as well?
Yeah, if I shake it. But the thing is, it's like e-paper or whatever, so it's not, you know. Oh, the creepy kitty. John Pose, how much money did Callie lose gambling in Vegas?
I don't gamble. Or I could just make a better story and say, oh man, I lost so much.
A ton.
I am not going to be able to live for the next year.
Oh, there you go.
Pablo doesn't have tuition this semester.
That's
yeah,
right.
I took Pablo's
tuition
money.
Pablo's not going back to college.
So it was a rough time.
Oh, that's Eventbrite. Never mind. That's just an email.
Okay. Are we ready to come back?
We're ready to come back. Welcome back, guys.
He just won't stop playing with his watch.
I'm John P.
And I'm Callie Lewis.
I just wanted to say I'm John P. just to force her to say I'm Callie Lewis.
I'm Callie Lewis.
You gonna say that a few more times?
No, because
we
it
could get it on
a
nice blooper reel.
I'm gonna talk about robots. I don't know about you.
Here we go.
Before we get into robots, though, I do want to know what's up with you stealing menus.
Oh yeah, I forgot. We didn't even talk about it. Look at this. Look what we have right here.
That is a menu from.
This is actually the menu at the Big Texan Steak Ranch.
Nice.
Oh, look, that's
the Big Texan is, real quick, a restaurant in Amarillo where if you eat a 72-ounce steak in an hour, I think, then you get it for free.
That's right. It's the home of the Big Texan Steak. So it's if you eat the whole thing, Where is it? I don't see. Where is it on the menu here? To the left, right
John,
here.
John, make it straight, please, so we don't get glare.
Oh, well, I don't know. Is that better?
Make it straight.
Like this. Okay. Well, here you go. There's Rocky Mountain oysters on
what
the menu.
Those? Kelly, tell us what those are.
I'm not talking about the Rocky Mountain oysters.
They're bull balls. That's what they are. And
those words
somewhere,
are not coming out of my mouth.
I don't see it. But anyway, on here somewhere.
Are those donkey balls?
Yeah, they're not. If you get the big Texan steak.
Yeah.
If
that's
you
what
don't,
I just said.
If you don't eat it, if you can't complete it, it's like $80. But only that's if you're up on the stage where they have two live cameras shining at you. If you try and do it from a normal table, $200.
Wow.
If you want to order one and have people split them.
Wow.
We did not get it.
All right. Well, I'm glad you stole menus on your road trip.
No, they gave it to me.
Let's talk about robots.
They gave it to me.
This is a very popular YouTube video from the DIY Laser Guy. He took a hex pod and attached lasers to it.
Oh, yeah. This is scary.
And the lasers are powerful enough that they can pop balloons. And they can light things on fire. As you know, those are two things that only happen with some of the most powerful lasers out there. But yeah, he's gotten quite a lot of views on this. And I'm looking forward to getting one, my hands on one.
I'm sure you are.
Because there are lots of things around here I would like to light on fire.
Don't be looking at me like that, little robot queen. You know what you're going to do with it.
Speaking of more robots, you know how much I love the Double, right? The
yep.
little Double telepresence
robot.
Well, they came in and just took the market by storm. They created this inexpensive telepresence robot that is unlike anything else on the market.
It's awesome.
Well, now we're seeing another entry into the market, Beam Plus. It's a $2,000 telepresence robot that's in similar fashion. It's not like a Segway on two wheels. It does have three wheels, so they've been able to lower the cost a little bit by $500. The first 1,000 units that go out are only going to be $1,000, though.
That sounds amazing.
It's a 10-inch display, 640 by 480, a 4-mic array, and battery life, unfortunately, is only 2 hours, though. So
this
that
is the problem.
Is the big problem that I see with this potential one, and I was really looking forward to getting it, but 2 hours is not
I don't even
enough.
Want it.
The Double actually lasts all day.
The Double lasts all friggin' day, plus 640 by 480 resolution?
Right.
What the hell? Are you getting these cameras at garage sales? 640 by 480? I mean, the Double uses an iPad, which means that it has the capability video-wise of whatever the iPad cameras
right.
are. Even the back camera is way better than that, okay? So who wants a telepresence robot that runs out of battery after 2 hours?
Yeah.
That's ridiculous.
It's
literally, you could not have a meal with your family remotely because the
right.
meal could last for 2 hours. And then what? The battery is just dead? Come on. We have got to have some information wrong. Even though I went to their website, I checked it out, and I even tweeted them saying, what's up with this 2 hour thing? Of course, I only did that right before we came
right.
on, so I haven't seen a response
maybe,
yet.
Maybe
but seriously, 2 hours is not enough, folks.
It's
Double
not.
Is still the king of telepresence robots, as far as I'm concerned.
But it is nice to see more entries into the market, at least.
That it is.
All right. Now, would you like to talk about any automobiles?
Of course we
and
would. It's auto time. Okay, first of all, this first one, even you are going to freak out.
Will I?
I promise.
In a good way?
Yes.
Okay, show it to me.
Do you remember when we went to Hawaii and
no.
you got on a four-wheel drive thing? And you drove like a complete maniac.
I loved it.
Okay, she loved her ATV. Now imagine taking an ATV and basically turning a truck into a full ATV.
What?
That's what you can do with the truck and go.
Nice.
Yeah.
OMG.
Look at this. Oh my God, look at that.
That okay. looks awesome.
Now here's what's impressive. There have been little tanky tread kind of wheel things for vehicles before. But what was involved in putting them on was you had to take the wheels off and, like, bolt these things on. It was really ridiculous. These Not like that. Right. These are little tracks. You just lay them out on the ground, drive over them, kind of finish the attachment, and bang! You're acting like this crazy psychopath driving everywhere on the off-road. Huh. Is that not awesome or what?
It is awesome.
Now, you want to know the bad news?
No.
$25,000 for a truck. So, yeah. They're about...
You really need to live in Alaska.
Yeah, they're about $6,000 per wheel. But hey, that's a small price to pay to be able to drive your truck off-road like that. That's awesome. Okay, moving on. Speaking of a small price to pay, it really doesn't matter what they're going to charge for this because you're going to want one. It's the new 600 horsepower Corvette Z06.
Woo!
What they did was it's based on the C7 Stingray, which is the most gorgeous vet they have maybe ever released.
Right.
Ever. But what they did was they took the 6.2 liter 460 horsepower with 460 pound foot torque V8. And they slapped an Eaton supercharger on that bad boy. So now we get it up to 625 horsepower, 635 pound foot of torque. You can get it with either a 7-speed manual or an 8-speed automatic with paddle shifters. That's the one I would opt for.
You love your paddle shifters.
I loves me some paddle shifting. And what can I say? You drive that big yellow flaming fiery bad mother, shut your mouth. I'm talking about Stingray.
Oh my gosh.
All over the place.
Really, John?
And that's it.
Well, that looks cool. I love both of them.
I'm spent.
And it's time to put down our iPads and tablets of all kinds and get on to the unboxings right after we come back from.
Before we do, we need to know what is the weirdest thing you've ever eaten out of a vending machine.
Well, I've gotten underwear out of a vending
machine. No, don't want to hear that. Go over to geekbeat.tv/famespot and let us know what it is. Underwear out of a vending
Japan.
Machine?
Japan.
Oh.
How'd it taste?
Actually, we couldn't find the...
So you eat vending machine underwear, huh?
No.
Yeah. We couldn't find the vending...
We couldn't find the underwear vending machine, actually.
We looked everywhere.
We did.
So we found the bread vending machine.
Are you wearing that vending machine?
Right. No, Green, you didn't miss the unboxings. We're getting to it now.
Yep. Unboxing coming up. Hello, Green. How are you?
She's a month off at home from school.
What?
Yeah.
Wow.
I told her I was jealous.
Wish I could get a month off from this.
Wasn't last week
just kidding.
Just
huh?
Wasn't last week just a big vacation?
Oh, yeah. We were in Vegas. I mean,
yeah.
Come on.
We were in Vegas.
Oh, yeah. That was no work whatsoever. Okay.
Hey, I'm just going to say that, John, you did an admirable job.
Of driving?
Of getting there without breaking breath. No.
Nice.
Of carrying the show, hosting the show as sort of the lead host. With a bunch of folks that are very, very good, but new to
live.
What's he doing? Why is he sucking up?
I don't know. I don't know what he wants.
What?
Apparently, he wants a new TriCaster. He wants a.
I mean,
I don't know what it is.
Is he out of popcorn?
Not small potatoes.
He wants something big. I don't know what. Why, thank you, Dave. I appreciate it. Thank you very much.
Digital Phil, if anybody made me a peanut butter sandwich, of course I would eat it. I love peanut butter sandwiches.
Petrock Media.
They're my fave.
Maybe I would actually watch an episode of John P. Drove the Corvette.
Now I want Taco Bell. I want a peanut butter sandwich. You people are ruining me. What? You're not going to drive
How
a Corvette?
How about a robot lobster that serves Twinkies? Nice.
Okay. I would go for that.
All right.
Pet Rock Media, you don't actually watch episodes?
Ruh-roh, YouTube stopped.
Ruh-roh.
Really?
Ruh-roh. Uh-oh. Peanut butter, banana, and honey. I have not tried that.
It's great.
I should try that. Oh, we have some honey from Alex Lindsay.
Oh, do we? Is that where the honey came from?
Yes, remember?
Oh,
I
forgot. That's right, he did
bring
honey. That's
for my
right.
Last week.
I forgot. Okay, let's do this. We're gonna unbox some shizzle. All
right, here we go.
My nizzles.
Here we go.
Uh oh.
Oh, John P. and with the watch.
Ugh, love this little watch.
he loves his pebble.
I think everybody should be able to check their email, get their texts, notifications.
How about make a phone call?
Well.
Yeah, I've got them over here.
I can't do that with the pebble, but I can do it with the Martian watch. I can talk like Dick Tracy. She hates it. She thinks I look ridiculous. I'm like, hello? Yes, I'll be there in 5 minutes.
Maybe I'm just too practical, but you do look a little ridiculous.
Yeah, that's what you're. I am not a crook. I am not a crook.
Let's open some stuff.
Boxes.
Yeah, let's see what we got.
This is not a box that was mailed to us. This is a box that was picked up.
Picked up?
By Pablo.
By Pablo.
I think he stole it. I'm not sure. I think he was shoplifting, and he came back with big buckets of stuff. He's like, yeah, I swear that he just gave it to me.
And we're like, okay.
Sure. They just gave it to me when they weren't looking.
Well, no. Open it up.
Anyway, what is this? This is a mantra.
What is a mantra?
It's from Om Audio.
Bluetooth, something or other. Is it headphones
I
or
don't
speaker?
Know.
What?
Here, open it.
You're too busy watching your SMS.
Unbox robots. Janie wants us to unbox some robots.
Oh, I don't know that we have any robots.
Yeah, okay. What do we got here?
Let's see. Oh, it's nice looking so far.
Well, that's okay.
I like the little carrying case.
I like the little carrying case. Right. That's nice. Why are you smelling it? Jared Polin. We don't do the smell test.
It has a new smell.
It does smell
like
rather fragrant.
Right, let's
see.
Open it up.
Oh, it opens from both sides, apparently.
Okay.
Oh, look at that.
Oh.
Cool.
So it's a little speaker. It's a Bluetooth speaker, it looks like.
It has a wood grained finish, a black wood grained finish.
Yeah.
And then it has a rubber foot on the bottom, so that will keep it, I guess, kind of from sliding around.
It looks well made.
When you crank it up, you know. I like the little exposed speaker here on the front.
Yeah, that is nice.
It looks like it has, I guess these are touch.
These look soft, but they're not. They have this like very specific look.
It must be a touch thing, because that's play,
pause,
and phone call.
Oh,
so I guess this is a speakerphone. And then on the back, what do we have? We have a port. For the bass, baby. It's Bluetooth. It has a USB a micro plug. And it has an auxiliary in. So you could use it to connect to some kind of a
Well, Paul actually device. Put the link in the chat room so you guys could check that out.
Oh, nice. How much are they?
Yeah.
How much is it, Paul? Somebody tell me how much it is.
I like the logo. The logo is kind of cool looking.
$99? Okay, $99.
And you can daisy chain.
They're good looking.
Oh, and you can daisy chain.
You can daisy chain them?
Nice.
Bluetooth. Oh, so you can pair up two of them and get stereo.
Nice.
Okay, let's see what else we got here. Here we go. This one came from FedEx.
All right. What do we have here?
What do we have here?
Nice. Men of Steel. We've got a Superman something or other. Oh, look at those.
These are Man of Steel earbuds.
New headphones for me to try out.
Anti-tangle flat cables with a built-in HD microphone.
All right, so
8mm
you can see
drivers.
They're blue.
And they have the little Superman.
They have like a little Superman logo right here.
Logo right there.
So do they have to license Superman?
They had to have. These are from Gavio, G-A-V-I-O.
And you can see the flat cable right here. It's like a clear plastic on top of the blue cable. It looks really nice.
It says flat cabled crystal clear earphones with mic from Gavio.
Cool.
We'll have to give them a shot.
They look nice.
Mygavio.com. MYGAVIO.com.
All right.
Let's keep it going.
What else you got?
I'm going to save this one
for
last.
I think I know what that is.
Okay, let's
Somebody's
see.
Somebody's going to be a happy man.
What is this right here?
There's
a black box.
Black box. We've got
with orange wrapping paper. You got a little letter there. You want to do that while we... There's a lot of stuff in here.
Stuff.
A lot of stuff. Here, move that off.
All right.
Oops. That didn't work. Okay.
Oh, okay, so tangle-free USB cables. It looks like it has three different colors here. I can't.
It's probably taped on or something. It probably requires
a knife.
That's my guess.
All right.
Let's see. What do we got? Okay.
You can see these are flat cables as well. Tangle-free.
Yeah, these things are.
What is this? A dual USB very secure universal charger. Oh.
There we go. You open it from the bottom and pull them out like that. Ah. Oh, they're nice and rubbery. They're like rubberized. Yeah, they're rubbery.
Nice.
Say rubber
Rubber. Rubbery.
This is a two-port USB charger, and it flips open to plug into the wall.
Nice.
How many milliamps do we have here?
Output is 2.1 amps for each port, so that's 2 times 2.1.
Oh, so it's not, yeah, this is not a battery. It's just for plugging into the wall.
But it's 2 times, it says 2.1 amps each port, so it's dual full port. So you can charge 2 iPads or tablets or hungry phones like our notes simultaneously. Hungry phonos. What is this? This is the Dashport dual output universal charger for any 2 tablets or devices at once. Rapid charge, it says.
And then we also have a car charger in here. So, awesome. Nice, John.
You like that?
That was good.
You know, this is actually a good looking little device. It's it's thin, it's gray.
It's rubberized again.
Oh, and so one of the ports is on the bottom, and one of the ports is on the side.
Oh,
and
I like that,
they have
actually
the nice gray soft touch. And yeah, how about that?
Cool, maybe somebody can...
Wait, this is 2.4 amps per port.
Wow.
That's a 4.8 amp charger. That's awesome. Very cool, okay.
Cool. That's
Let's see what else we got here. Here's another one. One
okay.
for you.
Okay, wow, look at all sorts of stuff. What'd you get?
I don't know.
Let's see. Oh, this is, okay, so there are a lot of Bluetooth speakers on the market, as you guys have been talking about in the chat room. This is looks like a little coffee cup. Look at that.
Yeah.
That's a speaker.
It's got a little
handle.
And it has
like a little mug. That is cute.
That is, and on the bottom here, we've got an on-off switch, a USB micro port, and an auxiliary input. And then we've got our play, pause, volume up and down, skip left and right. So that's kind of cute. If it was sitting on your desk, it just looked like a coffee cup.
Yeah, that is cute.
Stick it down in the cup, so in the cup holder.
Music cup, mymusiccup.com.
Mymusiccup.com. Yeah. All right.
What you got?
Let's see. One.
More speakers.
Two. We have three.
Yeah. Have
three in a box.
You want the pink one?
Yep, he gets a pink one. Okay, let's see. What do we have here?
This is Democracy by MA Audio.
Oh, the Democracy speakers. Okay, we've got different colors.
I'm going to need... Okay, here we go.
Slide it out the side, right?
Yeah, slide it out the side, and then it opens right up. So, there we go.
I like the packaging. I like their little, I like their designs on
them. They have a card that says specifically, we want to hear from you right at the top before you get into the speaker.
Nice.
Ooh, all right. How did I get, oh, the pink one, exactly.
You grabbed it. I don't know.
It was the closest one to me.
You're a girl.
You know how I, all right. What? Let's see.
Are you going to break it?
I might. I'm curious.
It says, one... Can only turn anti-clockwise. Don't turn more than 180 degrees.
Oh, I knew it did something.
Okay.
There we go.
Oh. Ooh, look at that.
You can adjust
look at that, Dave.
The speaker.
You can point it wherever you
cool.
want.
Cool.
Nice. So it points forward.
So, and on the bottom, you can route the cables to kind of hide
nice.
Which is nice. Got the charger right there.
USB.
Cool. They're lightweight too, but
they're
rubberized. I like rubberized gadgetry.
Why do we like those things so much?
I don't
it, just
know.
Feels
it just feels good
in your hand.
Yeah, you just want to touch it.
Yeah, it says, oh, built-in microphone. So these are actually speakers too. They're rechargeable battery, revolving access system, Bluetooth connectivity. So they do Bluetooth or they do the direct input. Or do we have different ones? Yeah, they all have Bluetooth.
Awesome.
So that's very cool.
No, I don't think his was smaller, Harumph. I think ours is the same size.
These are all the same.
Yeah.
Just different colors. We have white, black, and that one was pink, right?
Yeah.
Cool. Okay, move these over because we have one last thing to unbox today. This came from my friend Nick. who has a Kickstarter project going.
And this is the day I leave the office for good, right?
That I shared with you guys. And are you ready? These have never been seen before anywhere else. This is their world.
Are you the only one who has it?
I'm the only one.
Nice.
This is the world debut.
Okay.
Of his Kickstarter rubber band
nice.
Project.
You guys remember that? Ooh. Oh, it's already loaded, locked and loaded, ready
nice.
To go.
I'm gonna have to.
Wait. So are these two
oh,
different
now
ones?
This
no, is a 3D printed version.
That is. It's,
cool.
That is the only one in the world. No one's ever getting that. It's just a demo kind of thing.
Ow.
And so.
No one's getting it.
No. Nobody's getting the plastic one. This is just a proof of concept kind of thing because it's all 3D printed. It's really lightweight too. Oh, it's not loaded.
Oh, darn it.
So we're going to get these things loaded up, and as soon as we get off the show, and we'll shoot a little video to show you. We'll post it as a vlog. How's
Ooh,
that?
Okay.
We'll do a vlog about them. But you can order them, and they're really cheap. They're like $30 or something. You're going to
awesome.
Get the whole kit.
These things are really cool.
You can load them up with like 10 rubber bands, and notice when you squeeze the trigger, see how it keeps
oh, yeah.
incrementing that thing? It just increment.
Nice.
Yeah, it's going to be awesome. All right,
awesome.
Guys, we're gonna
right.
do a little video, and we'll show you later on. We'll be back next week if anybody around here is still alive.
Thank you guys so much for joining us. Be sure to follow John on Twitter or Google+ for more awesome finds like this on a daily basis. So go to google.com/+JohnP or twitter.com/JohnPoz, P-O-Z.
Or you could follow her. She's more important than me anyway. google.com/+CallieLewis and twitter.com/CallieLewis.
And thank you guys so much for chiming in the chat rooms and sticking with us all each and every day.
Yep.
All right.
Bye guys.
There you go.
Okay. Let me figure out how to load this bad boy. So I'm assuming we do that and hook this. Oops. This is going to hook right back here. Like that, and now, oh yeah, you just pull it back one. Yeah, you see this? You load that. Nope, they're two different projects.
Wow.
And you hook this over that,
and then
you
pull
that
back. Okay.
You see? And you pull it back. We're gonna have so many rubber bands all over the dang office, it's not even funny.
Ah, I just broke it.
You broke what?
One of them.
You broke a rubber band?
Yeah.
Oh, it misfired.
Okay.
Oh, wait.
Well, don't put it back in the box. Then I might reuse it.
How'd she shoot herself? Well, she was cleaning her rubber band gun and
yep.
it went off.
Yep.
How Oops. Many do you think you can load at once?
You can load about 10 or so.
How many cogs?
About 10 or
ah!
so. Oops, sorry. Hit you in the eyeball?
Yes.
Oh my god. It's a good thing you had your contacts in to block it.
She's like Ralphie. All we need now is
I can't believe
all
you.
Now is for you to stick your tongue on that.
No, I'm just keeping my left eye closed. Oh, I won't be anywhere near her. I didn't even start firing it yet and I already shot her eye out. Oh my god.
Oh.
And so it begins.
Yep.
Oh, that's so funny. I just said that. Don't shoot the talent. Someone slow-mo
yeah,
that, please.
John is going to shoot out Callie's eye.
And I sure did. Right there, I did it.
Wow.
Wow, I can't believe I did that.
That was too good.
I will never live that down.
No, you won't.
Never.
Somebody, do we have that on live or we're done, I mean, on the like actual stream or just drop cams?
No, it's streaming. And it's
oh, we're still streaming? Okay.
Yeah.
No, brother. I will never live
I
that
I want
down.
That as an animated
Oops.
GIF, actually.
I just broke
just
a rubber
over,
band, too.
And over and over.
Actually, I broke two rubber bands. Okay. Oops. I didn't load it right, I guess. There
yeah,
we go.
There it goes.
I didn't load it right. Oops. I'm sorry I shot you in your eye hole.
It's all right.
You'll shoot your eye out. You'll shoot your eye out. Yep. No, I'll shoot her eye out, apparently.
This isn't a big enough rubber band.
That's what she said.
Who wants to play? No pointing at them in Cali.
Yeah, that's been done. That's old.
You want to wait for this one. This one's just a prototype demo unit. It doesn't shoot as well as this one. This one, however, is a bad mother. Shut your mouth. I'm talking about rubber band gun.
Come on in, Lynn. Play. I know.
Yeah, you might lose an eye.
Yeah. You were in the what were you in?
Marines. Yeah, that would have been bad. That's how people lose an eye.
Some more candy.
It's what can I say? Just wait until the machine gun rubber band guns get here. Oh God Almighty! It's gonna be ridiculous. But this sucker is a 10-shot.
Shooting the intern is acceptable. You better watch out. Yeah.
I know he's gonna have to run. In just a minute, he's gonna have to run like the wind. Interns are for target practice.
Right.
Yeah, I told you that one. That one is really just a mock-up demo model. Oh, you got it to shoot?
Yeah.
This one, however, is the bad boy that shoots. And I'm gonna shoot him. Because I loaded them. Ugh.
Yeah, Jason, maybe I should wear goggles around here from now on. This would be just wearing safety glasses.
Okay, I'm finished loading them. I don't know how many I loaded, but there's about maybe 8 or so on there. Okay, here we go. Ready? I'm going to try and hit the lens of the camera.
All sorts of Bluetooth speakers. No?
Yeah. Oh, missed. Oh, got it.
Did you get it?
Oh, nice. Almost. Oh, yeah, got it.
You're out.
I'm out. That's pretty accurate, actually. All right, that was pretty fun. So apparently we have a call in a few minutes.
Oh yeah, what time is it?
It's 4:30.
We do.
I know this because my watch told me so.
Nice. I was wondering how you came up with that.
Not because I remembered, because right. I looked at my watch and I remembered the time was coming up.
Even though I reminded you like right before we started the show, but...
Yeah, that's not how I do.
Listen to me, so you need a Pebble watch to remind you of these things.
All I hear is
Jaybird said, ouch, you got me.
Nice.
Oh, okay, guys. All right,
well, we're going to go get ready for our call, and then I hope you guys have a great weekend.
Yeah.
And enjoy yourself. What did you do? Maybe you'll do something fun.
Pablo, what'd you do?
What are you guys doing this weekend, anyway?
Who, me? Oh, everybody.
I was asking the audience.
Yeah, anybody got any big plans? Vimini said, John P. Bladesmith. Marksman, not so much. Hey, I'll have you know I hit her eye with precision.
He was trying.
And it's repeatable.
Wallport, dual USB universal charger. Somehow you managed to pull it out and leave the cable in there.
That's what she said.
Oh.
Huh? No, I was putting it back in.
Come on, that was good, John.
Oh, I know, I laughed.
I was putting it back inside. In so that it would stay together.
Oh, okay.
I was doing it.
You know what you missed is this is a battery plus car charger. You didn't pull this one out. It's a battery.
I was trying to move along.
And a car charger, both.
Oh, that's cool.
The Power-R900 has a 900 milliamp battery. And it is also a charger with 2.1 amps output. So it's a full output car charger, 2.1 amps, but the battery puts out 1 amp. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So it's not a big battery, but it's like an emergency battery. Yeah. You leave this in your car,
right.
Let it charge.
I saw that a lot at CES.
Oh, did you?
Hey, you know what, John?
Huh?
That thing's actually pretty cool because you keep it in your car. Device in your car while you're running into the store or something, a lot of times the cigarette lighter turns off when you turn the power off.
That's true.
And your device will keep
I'm sorry. I can't get past the thought of leaving your phone in the car.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How does that work?
Some people can walk away from a phone.
Do you understand this problem?
My phone's always with me.
Yeah, he's like 12. He doesn't know what that means. He would get his implanted in him if he could. Okay, the one thing I'm wondering about this one is, if plugging it into the cigarette lighter automatically charges the battery, because it has a little micro input here, a micro USB input, push to activate battery function.
Hawkman, and I'm wondering if you have to, like, to John, I promise.
I'm wondering if you have to loop it back in so it charges itself.
Huh. That'd be interesting.
Charging via included micro USB cable, charging via PC, charging the power dash battery, charging via integrated in dash car charger. Okay, so you can actually charge this one of two ways. Putting it in the cigarette lighter automatically charges it, so it will always stay charged. Or if you carry it with you, you can plug in to the micro USB and charge it that way. I like it. That's right, you could. You could have it charging, you know, and, you know, wherever. And if you wanted to take your phone in and not leave it in the car, but you're not full, you just pull this out, take it with you. It's nice and compact. Yeah. Because it's not going to charge. I mean, having a huge battery that you carry into the store with you isn't going to help you anyway. You're only going to be in there for 30 minutes. Right. This will keep charging it. Then you come back, stick it in, keep charging it. And it will charge twice as fast when it's plugged in the cigarette lighter because it's pulling 2.1 amps. Mm-hmm. But when it's just on battery, it's 1 amp.
Nice.
So, hey.
It's very versatile. I like that.
I like it. Okay. All right, guys. I guess we're really going to let you know, go now.
Yeah, we have to go back to work.
Christopher Arnold is relaxing and getting started, ready to start a new job next week.
Nice. Congratulations.
Congrats.
I hope it goes well.
Eric is catching up on Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Is that already out?
Oh, my God.
What's the matter? That's been out for, like, since September.
Yeah.
Really?
I've been watching it every week.
Where do you watch it?
Hulu.
ABC.
Plus.
I did not know that.
Or, you know.
Yeah.
Right.
Bootleg. Wow. Well, I've got a lot of catching up to do.
Sign in on Hulu.
Okay, guys. We'll see y'all later. Have a good weekend. Bye.